السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما أما بعد يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون or you who believe fear Allah as he should be feared and die not except on a state of Islam May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us the favor to die on a state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd, yaqulu rabbul izzati subhanahu wa ta'ala fi surati Ali Imran. In the surah of Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا وأنتم الأعلون إن كنتم مؤمنين. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى addressing to the believers in this ayah do not be weak and do not be sad do not grieve and you are al-a'lawun al-a'lawun is you are the highest those who have the upper hand if you are truly believer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah addressing to the believers in the battle of the Uhud or after the event of the battle of the Uhud After the first round, when they had, you know, the defeat for a reason that we'll explain, insha'Allah ta'ala, within the topic of today. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an order, is a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, do not be sad, do not be weak. And then it's like first to comfort the heart of the believer. Second, also there's like in the speech or the command or the addressing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers, It's like strange, how can you be sad? How can you be, you know, have this deep anxiety? How can you have in yourself on the road of the depression? You are a believer. And before that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Khal, you are antum al-a'lawun, you are the highest, the people who have the upper hand. If you are a truly believer, so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing to you as a believer, you're going to put a question mark, you know, And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only He favored you by being having this position, but also He confirmed it to you. He said, you are al-a'la, you are the highest. However, as a believer, as a Muslim, someone will, when you reflect on this ayah, he said, you know what, I have a lot of problem. I have a lot of sadness. I'm going through, you know, worries all the time. Is that normal? Say, here is the question mark. Why are you having that? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you are al-a'la, you are al-a'la, you are al-a'la. So you're going to say, what does it mean? What does it mean to be the highest? Is this, you know, feeling like you know better than other people? It's not that. The highest the believer is al-a'la in his creed, in the way how he believes. He's al-a'la because he is with Allah. He's al-a'la because he followed the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying the deen, the Islam, the religion of Islam is the religion of everything, of all the messenger from Adam to Nuh, to Musa, Moses, to Isa, to all of them, to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Islam is the religion, is the way of every object in this universe. Islam is the way that the whole universe is behaving. Therefore, you are the highest, you are in this position being the highest because you have the creed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had pleased to give it as a gift to his servant. قال ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه. Whoever who take the path other than Islam, other than surrendering to Allah, other than surrendering one's will to the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from him. The believer is the highest regarding where he's going. He's going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, his aqidah is the highest. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قال هو الذي بعث رسوله بالحق ليظهره على الدين كله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his messenger with the truth to make it manifest and dominant on all the other ways or all the other religion. This is dominant in which way? In way of the proof, on the way of the evidence, of the way of how it really resonates and really it reflects one's inner nature. When he hears this message, it goes with his own senses, with the common sense. And when he's going, where are you traveling? You are traveling to Allah. Other people, they're traveling to nowhere. They said the grave is the end of our existence. Other people, they say, you know, there is some other who's going to help us. So you are the highest, not only your creed is Islam, but you are traveling to Allah. Then you are the highest because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the mission of vicegerency to take care of everything around you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dignified you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this great honor to make every object, everything in this universe is asking forgiveness for you. And the highest of the level of the angel, those the carrier of the throne, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Ghafir that they are making forgiveness for you. الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Imagine the carrier of the tremendous throne, the greatest creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those angels, one of their tasks is to first to celebrate the praises of Allah, but to ask forgiveness of the believers living on this planet Earth. So you are the highest if you have this way of reflection, if you have the thoughts, if you have the pride, if you have the pride that you are true believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only making you this, but Allah will be with you. That's why the believers say, I'm with Allah, I live by Allah, and I'm traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what makes for one to have that strength and that might. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever who looking for might, for strength, for empowerment in the heart, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah belong all the izzah. So anyone that he is seeking, you know, exaltedness or power or seeking, you know, way of being, you know, pursued happiness other than the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will not find it because Allah created us so. Then when we say al-a'la, the meaning of it, it's not like the people, for example, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described it in the Quran, the people who spread mischief on the earth. قَالَ تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ لَا نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًّا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا. The hereafter is not going to be for those who are seeking exaltedness, high position in this earth, nor those who are spreading the mischief. So the exaltedness of the believers is within a realm of wasatiyya, moderation within the way of Allah. It is the highest in the midst of the humbleness, in the midst of the center of the great moral and akhlaq. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he described it, the servant of the most merciful, قَالَ أَلَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا, those who walk on the earth with humbleness. And when the ignorant address them, they say peace. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامٌ. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you, believer, you are أنت الأعلى, You have highly regarded by Allah. You are honored by Allah. But on this planet Earth, you need to be a humble person. You need to be a peaceful person, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described you to be one of the servants of the most merciful. So then the next question, if you really embrace this and you adhere to this, and you're still feeling that subhanAllah tightness in the heart, that you're feeling a lot of problem, then what is the reason of it? What is the cause of it? The cause of it is like you make the gate of your tranquility other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You took as a gate toward your tranquility that you something that you believe in, that you feel secure toward, that what is giving you the happiness, that what you give you this tranquility, that what is giving you it's the peace of mind. If it's other than Allah, then you had opened on you the gates of worrying, of problem, of anxiety, and the path to depression. Wal'iyadu billah. Why? I'll give you examples. And this is example happened into among the believers, among the Muslims. Without knowing, you make your peace of mind to be in the stability of your family, for example. Everything is going great. But you do not have, as a member of the family, the control of any of your member of your family. If the husband does not have a control on his mate, or does not have control on his children, he's doing whatever he can do. If the mother, the same, she does not have control on the husband, he might do things that it really hurt her deeply. And when this has happened, subhanAllah, everything collapses. Feel like these people, they feel like, you know, like the whole earth constrained on them. It's like they feel like the whole earth like a cell, suffocating. Why? Because out of this deep hurting, out of this problem that they are feeling, you know, facing. Why? Because one of the spouses, he had done something. And here is the problem. You say, you know what the problem? The problem because you rely your happiness, your peace of mind on someone that he might change. Instead, if you had it attached to Allah, you'll help your member of your family to join you into this gate that leads to the true tranquility. Then if any one of them will collapse, if any one of them will change, you're gonna say peace. You try with them, of course it will hurt, but it will not affect you. But when you put, you rely all your happiness, all your tranquility, all your stability, all your peace of mind on something that it might change, then subhanAllah, you're going to be punished by the thing that you are, have your reliance on it. It might be a child, it might be a son, it might be, subhanAllah, a daughter, it might be a father, it might be a mother, it might be a business, it might be a career, it might be a job. Everything that you rely on is not happening in the crisis, you know, years ago, a few years ago, people, they, you know, they throw themselves from high rise. Why? Because all their tranquility, all their peace of mind comes from that big salary. Now that big salary is not existing, it's life ended. Why the gate of their tranquility is that peace or that subhanAllah six figure that they get or seven figure whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will for them. When it stops, their life stops. For the believer, when something like this happened to them and they feel deeply hurt, you're going to stand, you said, hold on, you are al-A'la. Allah is telling you in the Quran, don't you believe in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying? So the biggest problem is when we put the gate to find our tranquility, to find our peace of mind, something that is not in your hand, that is something that is, subhanAllah, is going to changeable, that it might change. You cannot control any one of your family to make them righteous, to make you love you. You cannot someone control someone who, you know, they bond with them to be always great with them. It's not gonna happen. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make for you a refuge for your heart to be with Allah. And if your heart with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you saved and you protected and you put your peace of mind into fortress. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be all the time with you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making you this and granting you this favor, and he's not getting anything from it. When you say, this is for the sake of Allah, or I'm doing this for Allah, and I have in my heart with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't you think, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is getting benefit from it? No. Then what are you doing when you have all your gate of tranquility relied on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then what is happening here is like you are honoring yourself. Because if you put your heart attached to anything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you put all your tranquility in threat, in real jeopardy that is going to collapse at any time. And when it collapses, you might not be able to come back. You might not be able to stand. Why? Because the hit was so big that you forget everything and you'll not be able even to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brother, respected sister, this is a very important topic. So when you say, how can I be regain my place of being in this high position, of being moderate, high position of being, you know, humble, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described, but you are high into your heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ. Those who believe and do righteousness, they are the best of the creation. Who are the best of the creation? Because your action is contributing in the welfare of the whole universe around you. People, they do not see it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you. And that's why one of the first step of your guidance, of your faith, of your iman, is to believe in this very small thing. They're not small for people who do not believe, but they are great and big for the believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us examples. If you take some example, just two examples of only one example, and you see anything that you do it in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you have your heart will incline to other than Allah, then you're going to have shortcoming, then you're going to have a problem as much as your heart had inclined far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this has given us a new idea or a new meaning of meaning fi sabilillah. Say, I do this in the sake of Allah. I give sadaqah in the sake of Allah. I'll pray in the sake of Allah subhanahu. I'm helping in the sake of Allah. Now, if you connect what I have said with the meaning of the sake of Allah, it has a very vast meaning. So we should not restrict it to only the sake of Allah, if we're giving sadaqah, or the sake of Allah, you're doing fasting. No. The sake of Allah, really, when we connect it, that's what is going to be your gate toward your tranquility, the gate toward your peace of mind, the gate toward your happiness, the gate toward your safety. That is the meaning of the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you want someone, for example, planning to get married, make it in the sake of Allah. What it means in the sake of Allah? Be careful, it does not mean like I'm doing it in the sake of Allah, so I'm giving everything for the sake of Allah, I'm gonna stay like with nothing. No, the sake of Allah actually is for you. When you do something and you initiate an action in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means that you're going to be looking forward to have Allah as a pleasure into that action. And if you look Allah as a pleasure into that action, then you're going to guarantee for that action to be free of anxiety, free of problem, and filled with a lot of blessings. Look, the Prophet ﷺ, as we mentioned the example of mates or spouses when they have problem, when they feel that their tranquility is based on the stability on their, you know, couple or household, and any one of them who does something that it hurt the other one, everything collapses. We gave that example. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't tell you when you're going to get married, think, get the one who had the deen, qala taribat yadak, you'll be blessed and at peace. Why? Because you enter the gate toward this marriage to make it in the sake of Allah, to make it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, if you make every action, every aspect of your life, that you make it in the sake of Allah, then you secure the gate of the path to tranquility and peace of mind by the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the way of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, for example, in the Quran, that when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said, oh Allah, enable me to be grateful to the gift that you have bestowed upon me and upon my parents. And yet Allah help me or enable me to do righteous action that you'll be pleased with. And in this ayah, there's a very profound meaning. It's not any right action, it's not any good deed. Is only the good deed that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So actually this ayah explain to us the meaning of the sake of Allah. When I do something in the sake of Allah, which is mean I make a good deed, I initiate, I plan a good deed, an action, a planning, based on the way of Allah, seeking that Allah will accept it. If you do such a thing, then your life become all of it in the sake of Allah. And some of the scholars, they have very beautiful statement which is extracted and inspired from a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قال, living in the sake of Allah is greater than die in the sake of Allah. Living in the sake of Allah is greater than dying in the sake of Allah. Because when you have all your life is, by the way, living in the sake of Allah does not mean like you're going to deprive yourself from the good pleasure of life. Actually, living the sake of Allah, you're going to enjoy the greatest of the pleasure of the halal. You're going to enjoy the sweetness of the iman. You're going to enjoy even the food with the rahmah of Allah, because you're going to taste it. Say alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you, keep for you that health to taste the good food that you like till the end of your life. It is not enjoying the pleasure in the way of Allah because you are doing it in the sake of Allah. The example I'll give you is the example of the ayah that I have mentioned. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in an event, if you take like an image in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where we had, if you describe some parts or parts of the life of the Prophet, in this part you find the highest level of acting in the sake of Allah. The highest level of acting in the sake of Allah, when someone is ready to give everything for the sake of Allah, his life, his money. So it happened when usually this has happened in battles. So in the battle of Uhud, the companion of the one Allah Ta'ala alayhim, without getting into details of the battle, but you know that some of the companion, they disobeyed the order of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam by leaving their position. But the most important, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, to apply what I have said in this ayah. Look what he said. قَالَ وَلَقَدْ صَدَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ إِذْ تَحُسُّونَهُمْ بِإِذْنِهِ حَتَّى إِذَا فَشِلْتُمْ وَتَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ وَعَصَيْتُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَرَاكُمْ مَا تُحِبُّونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has fulfilled His promise to you. In the sake of Allah, Allah will give you what you ask for. Allah will give you that blessing that He promised you. Because the action when you do it in the sake of Allah, it has its result. What is its result? All that blessing that comes from you from Allah. Forgiveness, a blessing, tranquility, peace, and so on. Qala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He did for you this. Till when you had disputed among yourself, and then you disobeyed after you have seen what you like. What you like, it was the beauties and the spoils into the battlefield. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then He said, some of you, they desire the life of this world. And some of you, they desire the akhirah. So we understand that what happened to the people, to the believers in Uhud, it was that inclination of the heart from dedication to the sake of Allah to the worldly life. This is exactly what we have said. So if we make the gate of our tranquility, our happiness, in the dunya, we're going to have as much problem as the way we have our heart to be inclined to the dunya. Look, the companion, I mean, we're talking about the best generation of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Because they disobeyed, Allah turned away from them and they painted, you know, in a very way, I will say, in hardship. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was wounded and his teeth was broken into this Uhud in result of this action. In result of the action. For the believer, ikhwani, to just summarize, the true believer, you believe in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you. You acknowledge that you have this high position in the way that we have explained. High position, the higher you get, the more humble you'll be. The higher you get, the more peaceful you'll be. The higher you get, the more righteous you'll be. That's the meaning of highest. And this is the higher you get into this level, the more security and you feel inside yourself. Therefore, this is striving to get the gate of the tranquility through Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the way how you're honoring yourself. And you're freeing yourself from anything around you that is really pulling you down and pulling you down in all the perspective, mentally, psychologically, you know, in the dunya, in your relationship, and all the aspects. So here, when you say everything, you turn it to make it in sabilillah, in the sake of Allah, all your life, then you're going to tell, you know, how am I going to do that? How can we do that? 20 is simple. Let's say when you say, I'm acting in the sake of Allah, everything I'm going to do it in the sake of Allah. First, what it means in the sake of Allah, as you said, you know, you say, this good deed, I'm going to do this good deed. Any action, it's a business and action. You say, if this is going to help me gain the pleasure of Allah. If it's helping to gain the pleasure of Allah, so this is going to secure everything you love for yourself. Not for Allah, everything you love for yourself. If it does not, he said, it's better leave it. Then you, when you do not know what you're going to do, that's it, the bounty of Allah and the mercy of Allah that he made for us, Salatul Istikhara. Salatul Istikhara, you ask Allah, Allah, choose for me. Why? Because Allah instructs you as his Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to make everything in the sake of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Now, when you said I'm acting in the sake of Allah, this is the definition of the meaning of the guidance. So he said, Alhamdulillah, so this is the guidance. So how can I define the guidance if I want to make all my action to be in the sake of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala? Say the guidance start with the principle. What is this principle? Knowledge. Knowledge of what? Knowledge that what Allah is telling you is the truth. It's very simple. Allah telling you are the highest, then you are. Then work on it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you, I promise you paradise. If you don't get to paradise, it's you who refused. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Everyone is going to paradise except the one who refuses. He said, Ya Rasulullah, who will refuse to enter paradise? He said, the one who denies the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's very simple. So when you say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when you have filled with anxiety, people, they are like, subhanAllah, at the brink to even end their life. We're talking about people around us. Say, if you look at yourself in the mirror, said, you should not be actually this way. Allah telling you, I just read it. I just heard it from the, you know, in the sermon today. I should not be like that. So what is my problem? Say, go back to the guidance. And first, settle your heart to accept what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the truth. Talk to yourself, this is the truth. This is, yes, I'm the good person. I am the highest person. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me, grant me this position. So I am the key for that. If not, I'm not feeling it because I am the obstacle for it. So the first point to start with, to make it very simple, is to think of your guidance as the greatest favor from Allah to you. And if you do, then you enter into the field of truthfulness. Then you become truthful to yourself. And then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate in you, and elevate in you based on your dedication or how much you want to be closer to Allah. And the closer you are to Allah, the less problem you will have. And when you have a problem, you understand that this problem into your favor, because you're going to say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, right? And then what is going to happen? He said, this is Allah who wants to purify me, as he did for the companion in Uhud. He said, وَلْيُمَحِّصَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, to purify you. When he purify you, he's going to elevate you. You're going to be in a level of patience. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I love الصابرين. So he elevated you in a position so that Allah will love you subhanahu wa ta'ala. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to make our life in the sake of Allah, and help us to make our life acting in his way, seeking his pleasure, knowing that living in the sake of Allah is greater than dying in the sake of Allah. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu al-ghafurur rahim. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the example right after the ayat in Surah Ali Imran. He said, many of الربانيون قال وكأي من نبي قاتل معها ربيون. الربيون, those who fear Allah, those who are humble, those who are kind, those who are peaceful, But they are in the sake, in the way of Allah, in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which is mean, they are so merciful, but they are angry when they see mischief. They stand truly for justice. They give everything to reestablish justice. With their effort, with their power, even when it comes, you know, something that is going to hurt them, they will stand for it and they fight for it. So this is the balance, highest in this type of the balance. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khal, this how many type of these people they fought with the prophets in the past. They didn't get weakened. قَالَ فَمَا وَهَنُوا وَمَا ضَعُفُوا. And they didn't have that weakness in the heart. And they being patient. And look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. And Allah loves the patient one. Subhanallah, if you reflect, these people, they are enduring difficulty, but they have a sweetness into this difficulty because it's not difficulty. Can you, someone who's going to fight for his country, say he's in difficulty? He's honored by all these, you know, his peers and all his people. So when you do such a thing, you are honored, but you are patient. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with this trial, He elevated you, put you in a level that you are proving patience. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from His aboveness, He say, I love the one who's patient, which is mean He's loving you. And then they said, and they're saying, they were, oh Allah, forgive us. Oh Allah, put firmness in our feet and our, you know, when you're meeting the enemy and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah grant them what they ask it, and Allah loves the muhsineen. Allah loves the good doers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate you to be from the patient, to give you His love, and then He elevate you to be from the good doer to make you in the highest rank. Which is mean, if you live today in that high rank, feeling that you are, have the upper hand, from the perspective we have described it, then you're going to come in the hereafter from those honored in the highest, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we put their book in Illiyin. And this is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala closed Surah Al-An'am. He said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Say, my prayer, my sacrifice, my life and my death is all for Allah. That is the life in the sake of Allah. That is the life that is greater than any other life. Even dying in the sake of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count for you every sajda, every prayer, every fasting. Because someone, people, subhanAllah, if you have a new day in your life, that's a new honor in your life to invest it in the sake of Allah. And that's how you guarantee for yourself to be from among the highest. And Allah will give you the help as He gave it to Musa alayhi salam when he was facing the people of Fir'aun and he felt fear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, قَالَ فَأَوْجَسَ فِي نَفْسِهِ خِيفَةً مُوسَى قُنَّا لَا تَخَفْ. Do not be sad, you are the highest. As every believer, do not be sad, you are the highest. If you are true believer, and a true believer means that you are true to your word, that you are truthful, and if you become truthful, then just surrender to Allah, and Allah will elevate you to maqam al-muhsineen, to the level of the muhsineen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and guide us and bestow upon us the gift of understanding, of listening the reminder and acting upon it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala correct our way, empower our heart, increase our iman, increase our reliance on Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and grant us the great gift to have our life lived in His sake, lived in His sake to get, insha'Allah, the tranquility and the true sweetness of the iman. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana ajma'in. Allahumma thabbitna ala siratil mustaqim. اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا وارحمنا فإنا ظالمون. اللهم لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.